I'm going to talk on a paper called EfficientNet, Rethinking Model Scaling for Convolutional Neural Network by Ming-Hsin Tan, Kwok. So these are the table of content which I will be going through. I'll be first talking about the motivation, the introduction, proposed method, experiment, results, and finally the conclusion. So the motivation of this paper is, how are we able to study the model and balance the network depth with and the resolution in order to increase the performances in terms of efficiency and accuracy. So we need to search for the hyperparameter that can find the optimal width, the depth, and the resolution effectively. Deep convex are often over-parameterized, and at times, model compression is a common way to reduce the model size by trading accuracy for efficiency. So the key motivation here is how to design an efficient model and maximize the accuracy of the model by extensively tuning the network parameters. Convolution network has been a preferred solution for a variety of tasks in the deep learning in recent years. So it has achieved a good classification performances. In order to like beef out the performance of the accuracy, certain ways like attempts to scaling up the convolution network have been studied. For example, scaling up the ResNet model from ResNet 18 to ResNet 200 by extending the network depth or layers. The most common way is to like scale up the convolution network by their depth or width. Another less common way is to scale up model by image resolution. So there are three dimensions of a CNN can be scaled, which known as the depth, the width, and the resolution. The depth is simply mean by how deep the network is, which is also equivalent to the number of the layers in the model. Whereas width denotes how wide the network is. And lastly, the resolution is the image resolution that is being passed to a CNN, which has been illustrated here. Although it is possible to scale up two or three dimensions arbitrarily, arbitrary scaling requires a tedious manual tuning and oftentimes has a suboptimal or not so optimal accuracy and efficiency. Instead of scaling every dimension to get the best out of the model, the author proposed a new scaling method that can uniformly scale all the dimensions of the depth, width, and resolution using a simple yet highly effective compound coefficient. So intuitively, if let's say the input image is bigger, then the network would need more layers to increase the receptive field and more channels to capture more fine-grained patterns on a bigger image. For instance, if we want to use a 2 to the power of n times more computational resources, then we can simply increase the network depth by alpha and the width by beta and image size by gamma. And all those constant coefficients can be determined by grid search. So what is grid search? So grid search is a process of performing hyperparameter tuning in order to determine the optimal value for a given model. So it is essentially doing a grid search in a search space, and every hyperparameter setting is evaluated until it finds the optimal combination. As you may know, a convolution net layer can be defined as y equals function of x, whereby f is the operator and y is the output tensor. X here is the input tensor with a tensor shape of H W and C. H W and C, where H and W is the spatial dimension and C is the channel dimension. So under the resource constraint of depth, width and resolution, we have to identify and find ways to maximize the accuracy of the model. The main difficulty is that these three dimensions, H, W, and C, they are highly dependent on each other, and the value change under different resource constraints. So we will first talk about the depth. Intuitively, deeper convolution network can capture richer and more complex features and generalize well on a new task. However, deep networks are also very difficult to train due to the vanishing gradient issue. Although several techniques such as the skip connection and batch normalization have been devised in recent years to alleviate the training issue, it creates diminishing return on the accuracy side. And next, for the width, wider networks tend to be able to capture more fine-grained features and easier to train. The drawback is extremely wide but shallow network tends to have difficulties in capturing higher level features. And lastly, the C, which is the resolution. As we know, with a higher resolution input images, the model can capture more fine-grained patterns. The better the resolution, the better the accuracy. But then the accuracy gain will come to a state where it will be saturated at some point of value. So therefore, it leads to the intuition where three dimensions can be coordinated and balanced with a constant ratio rather than scaling each of the dimension with a conventional way. So it is very imperative to balance all these three dimensions of network during this scaling process. So in this paper, they propose a new compound scaling method which uses a compound coefficient to uniformly scale the network width, depth and resolution, so that there's a parameter phi. It is a user specified coefficient that controls how many resources are available for the model scaling, while alpha, beta and gamma, which these three specify how to assign these extra or additional resources to the network with depth and resolution respectively. So how do we come up with this constraint? As we know, in a CNN, convolution layer are the most computation expensive part. Also, the flops of a regular convolution operation is almost proportional to D, W squared and R squared. That is, doubling the depth will double the flops. And while doubling the width and the resolution increases the flop almost by 4 times. Therefore, in order to make sure that the total flops don't exceed 2 pi, the constraint applied is close to 2. That's how we get this constraint. Since the model scaling does not change the layer operator in the baseline network, having a good baseline network is very important. The author evaluate their scaling method using the existing convolution networks. And by tuning that, they develop a new mobile size baseline called EfficientNet. starting from the baseline, efficient B0, these are the steps where how they use their compound scaling method applied to their model. There are two steps. The first step is to fix the phi with 1 and then do a small grid search of alpha, beta and gamma. Particularly, we find the best value for the model under the constraint that is very close to 2. And then, after they find the value for alpha, beta and gamma, they fix the alpha, beta and gamma as a constant and scale up the baseline network with a different phi to obtain efficient net B1 to B7. In this way, it uses the most minimal cost to search for the hyperparameter of a large model. And at the same time, it has the better performances of all. So it actually cut down the complexity of finding the best hyperparameter. So in this experiment, we will first evaluate the proposed scaling method on the existing convolution network, which are the mobile nets and also the ResNet. They have been widely used in the research. So as we can see from the table here, multiple scaling methods were implemented on the model in a different way, as in manually tuning the network depth, width and resolution, and also the new proposed method, compound scaling. From the result here, compared to other single dimension scaling method, the compound scaling method gave a more promising result on the accuracy on all these models, and suggesting that the effectiveness of the proposed scaling method for a general existing convolution network, they have a higher top 1 accuracy in the compound scaling compared to the other single dimension scaling with a similar flop. Flops is a floating point operations. It's actually a measure to compute the activation function of the matrix function. Next, they also train their proposed compound scaling method on the newly proposed efficient net. As for the flops accuracy figure right here, the scale efficient net model achieved a better accuracy with way much lesser parameters and flop required than the existing convolution network. In other words, the accuracy in efficient net model is way much better, even the model is smaller and computational cheaper than the convolution network. So compared to the ResNet 101, the efficient network B3 has outstanding accuracy with a lesser flops. Next, the figure here shows the image net performance of a different scaling method for the same efficient net model. So using the efficient net B0 as a baseline, different scaling methods are implemented to evaluate their accuracy. Overall, we can see that the accuracy increases with the scaling method. However, one should take note that the proposed scaling method has shown better accuracy performance by a margin of nearly 2.1% compared to other single dimension scaling, which is 81.1%, while the rest are around 78 to 79%. By doing the compound scaling this, it has a better accuracy with 81.1% compared to the other single dimension scaling. To further understand why the compound scaling is better than the others, figure here shows the result on comparison of a class activation map. So images here are randomly picked from the ImageNet validation set. As the figure illustrated here, the model with a compound scaling method tends to focus more on the relevant region with more object details, whereas the other model are kinda lack of object details or unable to capture all object in the image. So all in all, the author has devised the scaling method by uniformly scaling the network depth with resolution with a constant ratio instead of single dimension scaling method. They propose a simple yet highly effective compound scaling method which helps to scale up the baseline convolutional network to any target resource constraint in a more principled way while maintaining the efficiency of the model. Also, the EfficientNet model that has been developed proved to be able to attain the state-of-the-art accuracy with a much, much lower parameters and flop compared to the other convolutional networks.